Question answer on our country, India. Name the major physical divisions of India. So the major physical divisions of India is the Himalayas, the Northern Indian Plains, the Great Indian Desert, the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plains, and the two group of islands. India shares its land boundaries with 7 countries. Name them. So Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, China, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and Afghanistan. So this is, if I can make India like this. So here it is Pakistan, then Afghanistan here. Then we have China, Nepal, Bhutan, and Burma here. And then this part is Bangladesh, and here is Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka, it's not actually, you know, it is sharing boundaries, but still, because there is a, you know, strait here, that is why we include it. Which two major rivers fall into the Arabian Sea? So the rivers Narmada and Tapi, they fall into the Arabian Sea. Name the delta formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. So the Sundarbans delta is the name of the delta. How many states and union territories are there in India? Which states have common capital? So there are 29. Let me make it as 29. Why? Because Telangana is also now a state. So there are 29 states and 7 union territories in India. And Chandigarh is the capital of 2 states, Punjab and Haryana. Why do large number of people live in Northern Plains? So Northern Plains are generally flat and level land, having alluvial deposits laid down by the forests, the rivers such as the Indus, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra, and their tributaries. So these river plains, they provide fertile land for cultivation. This is very important. This alluvial deposit is responsible for the fertile land for cultivation. Therefore, a large population prefer to live here. Why is Lakshadweep known as a coral island? So Lakshadweep is made of corals, which are skeletons of tiny marine animals called as polyps. Take the correct answer. The southernmost Himalayas are known as Shivaliks. Sahyadris is also known as, it's the Western Ghats. The Park Strait lies between the countries India and Sri Lanka. The Indian island in the Arabian Sea are known as Lakshadweep Islands. And the oldest mountain range in India is the Aravalli Hills. India has an area of about, this is fill in the blanks, this is 3.28 million square kilometer, or you can say 32.8 lakh square kilometer. The great Himalayas are known as Himadri. The largest state in India in terms of area is Rajasthan. The river Narmada falls into the Arabian Sea, Narmada and Tapi. The latitude that runs almost halfway through India is Tropic of Cancer. Then this is the multiple choice questions. Choose the correct option to complete the statements. USA has how many? USA has, see, I'll give you an answer here. Has 7 zones. Russia has 11 zones. India belongs to the, where does India belong? It belongs to the Eastern Hemisphere. The island neighbors of India are, this is Sri Lanka and Maldives. These are island neighbors. Those land, which are actually islands. They have sea around it. Which state is the smallest one in terms of area? Goa. The other name of Middle Himalaya is, it's called Himachal. Which island groups were affected by the tsunami in 2004? So it's Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Fill in the blanks. India is the second most populous country of the world after China. The Himalayan mountains are divided into three main parallel ranges. The Great Indian Desert lies to the western part of India. Dash and Dash are west flowing. Narmada and Tapi are west flowing rivers that fall into the Arabian Sea. Lakshadweep Islands are located in the Arabian Sea. The western coastal plains are very narrow, very narrow. Now, true and false. Lakshadweep Islands are coral island, and this is true. The eastern coastal plains are much broader. No, it is false. They are narrower. The northern Indian plains lie to the south of Himalayas. This is true. The Bay of Bengal lies east of India. East of India. And this is true. The Arabian Sea lies on the west. Canada has 5 time zones. This is false. High concentration of population is found in plateaus. And this is also false. The high concentration is found in the plains. Now we have to match the items. The Great Himalayas, will match it with in the north of India. Bay of Bengal with east, the direction is east. See, if this is India, I'm just making a rough sketch. So here it is, the Bay of Bengal is this here, this sea. The Arabian Sea here. So we will link it with west. The Indian Ocean, we'll link it with the south. This is the Indian Ocean. See, this is Kashmir, this is Kanyakumari, this is Gujarat, and this is Arunachal Pradesh. That is how. The Peninsular Plateau, we'll link it with triangular in shape. This is triangular in shape, like this. The Eastern Ghat, we'll match it with broken and uneven. The Western Ghat width is continuous. The Eastern Ghat is broken. What is the north-south extent of India? The north-south extent of India is around 3200 km from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. What is the east-west extent of India? It is around 2900. The east-west extent from Arunachal Pradesh to Kutch, this is in Gujarat, is about 2900 km. How does the local time change? The local time change by 4 minutes for every 1 degree of longitude. So this is longitude. 1 degree longitude means 4 minutes. What is the difference between the time of sunrise in Arunachal Pradesh and Gujarat? So the difference is around 2 hours. The difference between the time of sunrise in Arunachal Pradesh and Gujarat is 2 hours. On what basis have the states been formed? On the basis of language. So the states have been formed on the basis of languages that are spoken in the region. What does Himalayas mean? Himalayas means abode of snow. Himalaya. So you can say home of snow. Where are the world's highest peaks located? They are located in the Great Himalayas or Himadri. What is peninsula? So peninsula is a piece of land surrounded by water on all the three sides. So if you go down south India, this is Tamil Nadu, we have Kerala, etc. here. So this is a shape of, this is the peninsula, 1, 2, 3 side. Here we have Bay of Bengal, here we have Arabian Sea, and here the Indian, the ocean we just talked about. Define the term desert. So the desert is a dry, hot, and sandy stretch of land with very little vegetation. Name the two important hill ranges that lie in the peninsula plateau. So Vindhyas and the Satpuras, these are the two important hill ranges that lies in the peninsula plateau. What is called the mouth of the river, and this is called the point where river enters the sea. If this is sea, now rivers come and it meets to the sea, it meets with sea, and this is called as mouth of river. What are polyps? Polyps are very small marine animals. What is the difference between western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains? So the western coastal plains are very narrow, while the eastern coastal plains are much broader. Name the rivers that fall into the Bay of Bengal. Means if this is India, this is the Bay of Bengal side. This is the down south. So Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri, they fall into Bay of Bengal. Mention the political and administrative divisions of India. So India is a very vast country. So because of this administrative purposes, it is divided into 29 states. 29 states, one has been added, that is Telangana, and 7 union territories. Delhi is the national capital of India. The formation of states has been made on the basis of the languages. Rajasthan is the largest state, while Goa is the smallest state in terms of the area, the region. These states have been further divided into districts. Write a short note on the coastal plains of India. So the coastal plain lie in the west of the Western Ghats and east of the Eastern Ghats. So the Western Ghat plains are narrow, while the Eastern coastal plains are much broader. So there are several east flowing rivers like the Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. So these are the east flowing river, and these rivers, they form fertile deltas at their mouth. Write a short note on the two groups of islands of India. So two groups of islands of India are Lakshadweep Islands and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So Lakshadweep Islands are located in the Arabian Sea. These are coral islands located off the coast of Kerala. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands are located in the Bay of Bengal. How are coral islands formed? So this is an example of coral island. So the corals are actually skeleton of very small animals called the polyps. So when the living polyps die, their skeletons are left, and other polyps, they grow on top of this hard skeleton, which grow higher and higher, they're therefore forming the coral island. What do you know about the boundaries of India? Explain in brief. So our country has a vast geographical expanse, north to south and east to west. In the north, it is bound by lofty Himalayas. In the west, Arabian Sea. East, it is bound by Bay of Bengal, and in the south lies the Indian Ocean. Describe the geographical extent of India. So India, let me make like this. So this is Kashmir, this is Kanyakumari, this is Gujarat, this is Arunachal Pradesh. So India has an area of 3.28 million square kilometer. The north-south extent means from this point it is around 3200 kilometer. From this point it is around 2900 kilometer. That means the north-south extent from Kashmir to Kanyakumari is about 3200 kilometer, and the east-west extent from Arunachal Pradesh to Kutch, that means from this point is about 2900 kilometer. Here we have lofty mountains, the Great Indian Desert we have here, the Northern Plains, the uneven plateau surface, and the coast and islands like this. The coast and the islands, Andaman Nicobar Islands and these Lakshadweep, these are islands present. They form a diversity of landforms. Describe the local extent of India. So India is located in the Northern Hemisphere. The Tropic of Cancer around 23.5 degree north pass almost halfway through the country. From south to north, mainland of India extend from 8 degree 4 minute north to 37 degree 6 minute north. These are latitudes. From west to east, India extends between 68 degree 7 minute east and 97 degree 25 minute east longitude. So if we divide the world into eastern and western hemisphere, India would fall in eastern hemisphere. Describe the effect of east-west extent of India on time. So the west to east extent leads to difference in local time from meridian to meridian. So the local time changes by 4 minutes for every 1 degree change, 1 degree of longitude. So the sun rises 2 hours earlier in the east, that is Arunachal Pradesh, than the west, that is Gujarat. The local time of longitude is 82.5 degrees, that is 82 degrees 30 minutes east. This has been taken as the Indian standard time, and the longitude is also known as the standard meridian of India. So its time is taken as the standard throughout the country. That means whole country will have the same time, which is at this longitude. Describe the major physical divisions of India. So India has a diverse physical features like mountains, plateaus, plains, coast and island. So the Himalayas stand sentinels in the north. The Himalayas mountains are divided into three main parallel ranges. The northernmost in the Great Himalaya is called the Himadri. The world's highest peaks are located in this range, Everest, etc. Middle Himalayas or Himachal lies in the south of Himadri, and the Shivalik is the southernmost range. Then we have the northern Indian plains. They lie in the south of Himalayas. They are usually level and flat, and these are fertile regions and suitable for cultivation. Thick population is found here. Then we have Great Indian Desert. It lies to the western part of the country. It is a sandy stretch of land. Rainfall is very less, very poor. Hence, very little vegetation is found here. Then we have the peninsular region. So it is triangular in shape. It lies in the southern plains. Its relief is highly uneven, and numerous hill ranges and valley are found here. The Aravalli hills lie to the northwest side. So the Vindhyas and the Satpuras, these are important ranges, mountain ranges. The Narmada and Tapi, if they flow through these ranges, and these west flowing rivers fall into the Arabian Sea. So in the west of the plateau lie the Western Ghats, also known as the Sahyadris. On the east lie the Eastern Ghats, and this plateau is rich in mineral like the coal and the iron ore. Then coastal plains, they lie to the west of the Western Ghats and east of the Eastern Ghats. The river Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri, all east flowing rivers, they fall into Bay of Bengal. They have formed fertile deltas at their mouth. Then we have islands. Two group of islands are integral part of the country. Lakshadweep islands are located in the Arabian Sea, while the Andaman and Nicobar island lie in the southeast of the Indian mainland in the Bay of Bengal. On an outline map of India, show its neighboring countries. So this is India. Here it is Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar and Sri Lanka. On an outline political map of India, show all the states and union territories. So this is, you know, in your book it's quite clear, this is just an idea, that we have 29 states and 7 union territories. So this is a political map of India, which is showing states like the Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, all these. And here we have Andaman Nicobar, here we have the Lakshadweep, etc.